Crusader Caravans Melbourne, Victoria, the Melbourne dealership here in Campbellfield. Today we've just had our brand new stock CRV Gladiator arrive, so we've taken the opportunity first of all to be able to make you a video, second of all to show you what this little guy packs. There's a heap of videos out there, but we'll show you the reasons why we love it at the dealership and why it's an absolute awesome addition to the Chameleon CRV range. Before we jump inside to show you how compact and hybrid featured this guy is, we're going to show you the outside. So standing underneath me right now, we've got a 13-foot box awning by Dometic. Obviously, you've got the arms up and down just like so. Alternatively, you've also got clip points right to the side of the van, so you can have it out, in, up to you, wherever you want to be able to sit him down. Underneath our awning clip point and highlighted by the Gladiator name, we've got outside TV point, standard in the CRV, so we've got 12-volt socket, aerial port, double power point and TV. Also helps for a bit of leveling as well, and that just closes up neat and tidy is there. We've got a drop-down picnic table, locked with a key of course, holds about 20 kilo. We've got outside speakers for outdoor entertainment, as well as a full-lit annex light right here at the front, and huge LED spotlight at the front. Unlike all the hybrid markets, this guy's manufactured and made here in Australia, completely from Australian products, including 3mm 450 MPa graded steel chassis. So it's running on an Intel Engineering chassis, 6-inch A-frame, 6-inch chassis, 16-inch tyre with a 2.7-tonne independent tough ride, giving you a massive payload, about 1,200 kilos depending on how much you're going to load it up, but perfect for the 2.122 tow vehicles, still giving you ample 600 kilo-ish payload. You've got a crim-safe solo door, so we've got 3 tri-locks on there, crim-safe mesh of course, with locked pull-down blind. So the pull-down blind here, just at the top, full block out there as well. For the solo women travelers, this is an awesome addition. So you've got that crim-safe and the protection security measure, so you can feel nice and safe while you're doing a bit of your free camping. We have a lot of solo travelers, females and males, going around and absolutely loving the CRVs and the Chameleons. So this guy here just adds to that addition, gives you a whole different dynamic of living. We've got, as mentioned before, 16-inch wheels. We've got a plastic covering, easy to be able to use and utilize. This is a high-dense strength plastic, as well as 2.7-ton tough ride dual-shock trailing arm suspension. All Australian-made manufacturer. We've got our jacking point underneath here just for lock-in point, as well as our 6-inch A-frame running right back to the wheels and 6-inch chassis to create a 12-inch sub-body frame. Gas bayonet, so we've got outside cooking just here at the front, so you can pop in a gas bayonet, cook your Weber Q, do the trick, very, very easy. You've got checker plate line tunnel boot, as well as a wide open hatch door locking point. We've got our manual 3-meter awning, so this guy goes up and we rotate. On the roof, just up the top, we've got a Dometic HV high definition boosted channel aerial. You've got a wind-down drop-down leg, a brace to be able to take changed wheels. You've got a trail mate jack there for a hydraulic pump, so really easy on the hands, really easy on the arms for lift up to be able to change up your tires. Double glazed Dometic windows either side of the van, so it's dual glazed. It's going to be able to stop the heat, stop the retention. This is a Dometic European manufactured product with blockout screens and midget-proof fly screens on the way through. As far as on the front, we've got a generator slide on one side, on the off side there, and we've got a Weber Q slide. So we've also got a reinforced toolbox lid. So this guy here, as far as mounting bikes or anything to it, it is an awesome addition to the range. So you can just pop them just on the top there. Raptor Australian-made toolbox, so fantastic. You pull this guy out, you can pull off just like that, and we can do some outside cooking just here off the A-frame there. And then once you're done, after you've had a few beers, you want to be able to pop him away, he just locks away nice and snug. This guy closes off here. One thing that really highlights the Gladiator is the awesome graphics on the side. So it stands out. We like a little bit of color, a little bit of flair, especially for that hybrid market. So Crusader have about 12 different colors you can choose for the striping, as well as 5 different interior colors as well. Making our way over, we've got a stone guard with mud guard protection. Mesh on there on the front, tap protector, regulator protector, obviously inside the toolbox there. DO35 coupling for rotative and full up and down movement, semi-recess coupling. We've seen these tow out with Volkswagen Tiguans, we've seen them tow out of here with the Hyundai products. Most vehicles that 2223 mark, this is only tearing at just over that 1500 mark. So a heap of wriggle room, a heap of movement as well in the payload allowance. But most vehicles, given it's a fully composite caravan construction, the actual weight saving on it is fantastic. We've got a winding, very easy to use jockey wheel just there, front winding. Running on this is a Anderson plug, as well as a 7-pin flat, with most vehicles will come standard with, either that or a 12-pin. On this side of the van, guys, we've got another access door for our LPG storage bowls. So we've got 2 9-kilos, so very easy to pull off. locking strap comes off, pull this guy off, refill the gas bottle. But in a van this small, there aren't many gas appliances. So as far as usability wise, you're really not gonna be going through these too much at all. Fill one up, put a 9 kilo in, put a generator on the other side. It's completely up to you. It's your caravan, it's your trip. So you can pick and choose as to how and which you wanna use that. Spotlight there on the front. So that guy has an independent switch just here on the front. So that's gonna light up a huge area. They pull about 7 amps worth of power. There's a huge amount of power consumption used by them, and they're an absolutely fantastic light. Charger just in here, we've got our 10 amp fuse. We've got a fuse bank just across here, PM200 system. So this guy here is awesome. It's gonna be doing all the charging for you, all the solar controlling as well. Again, close this guy off, another storage spot just like that as well. Drop down legs, front, back and rear. You've got 4 drop down legs for support. We also have our battery with outside breaker protection. This is a lithium, so 105 amp lithium battery, which means it is obviously, you know, a step above the AGM that most manufacturers within this sort of hybrid market are fitting, but it's gonna give you all the versatility and all the need you need for this particular van to be able to do some of those long extended free camps, the equivalent of 2 AGMs. We've got, again, 16-inch tires. We've got a 28 litre gas and 240 volt stainless steel unit, so no anode, no maintenance whatsoever. 2 95 litre water filler caps, as well as a grey water as well underneath there. So that's got all of the bash plate protection underneath there. We've got protection, empty valves. We've also got our grey water tank outlet, and we've got wrapped conduit pipes. Quick fill main system, so you plug your hose here, you don't even have to use those side fillers. We turn this here, it's gonna suck water straight into the tanks. Very, very easy to use. So this is pulling water straight into that right now. You've got mud flaps there on the back with a bash plate battery protector, mains plug here on the inside, as well as a fuse panel just there on the back, and side markers all the way across. In a van this small, they've still managed to fit a toilet. So this is our toilet, toilet carry case with our little handle and drop down wheels. So this guy just goes back in here, and a fill tank as well, just here on the side. Making our way through, we've got side clearance lights. So they're an auto LED product, so absolutely fantastic. We've got our 16-inch spare tire and wheel, as well as reinforced bumper bar on the back with license plate carrying point as well. Rear window on there on the back to let a heap of light. And again, a massive spotlight. They're like $400 a light. There's something amazing about these, and they do a fantastic job with the infrastructure and also the thought process behind all the LED products on the outside. So enough of the boring stuff. We can show you on the inside, and you will not believe how compact and versatile this van is. So outside entertainment, you're covered. Inside entertainment, we've got a high-rise step here at the front. Most people take a little portable one with them as well, and we jump straight in it. So straight away on a day like today, although we've got jumpers on, it is really well insulated. It is really, really well built. And all the composite panels on the roof and the sides and the floor are reinforcing and obviously making the temperature inside the caravan really well insulated. It's holding the heat, it's keeping the cold, it's doing everything it should, just like a freezer panel. There's no timber used in the sidewall, roof, floor, or front wall construction of the Chameleon and the CRV range, like the Gladiator. This guy here is a step above the rest, all Australian made, all the panels here, fabricated, made, and constructed. Nothing from China. The hybrid market doesn't need another Chinese product, and this is something that Crusader are bringing to the forefront of construction ability. So there's really not much you have to add to these. About 10 or 12 options you can add. The options we've upgraded in this are black pack, so we put a little few black handles in here and stuff to just option it up. Otherwise, you don't have to go that. You can go back to the standard stainless steel, everyone's used before product, but alternatively, we've given it a little bit of flair here. So I'll show you around the CRV. It's like one swoop around, and you'll see why we love it. First of all, we've got a table that swivels around. This guy here has a dual function. So first of all, it has a swivel function. So of course, I'm sitting on the bed, we're having something to eat. Alternatively, underneath here as well, there's a little spin around the mechanism, and you can actually start moving and turning this guy all the way around. It also serves as the bed between the two tables just here. This comes off, it drops these two, and the two beds can come together. So it sits just on that little ridge there, and then you can actually drop the table down. This guy here, if you unscrew it enough, bear with me 2 seconds, I'm learning on the job. This guy can pull up off of that. The table then serves as its own purpose. The table leg tucks on the floor just there, but there's really, most people use this bed as two single beds and use it as it's intended. Alternatively, if you're a solo traveler and you want to make more room for yourself, you want to have a bit of a cuddle with a partner, alternatively, you're taking two blokes away and you're going to go shooting, whatever it may be, this guy has it. So you've got single beds, double bed, e-sweep, whatever you need, the CRV Gladiator has it on offer. So at our bedroom just here, we've got two reading lights like so, black with USBs located underneath. Alternatively, without the black pack, they're obviously a standard. Silver. We've got two inner spring mattresses. So these guys are an inner spring, not a foam. They're an Australian made inner spring 2-year warrantable mattress. We've got, check this out, a massive amount of storage. That guy there pulls out, that is the biggest pot drawer, biggest shoe drawer, biggest whatever drawer in all of Australia. You've got pop up pressure hatch, just like so. We have massive overhead cupboard storage. You've got three of these guys all the way across the van. You've also got wind-up Dometic HV aerial and accompanied by, but not set up here, a 24-inch TV. So our 24-inch TV slots into this area here. You've got our booster, a double power point, of course, double power point, 12-volt socket. We also have a Sirocco fan, so when it's a bit warm, you can pop this guy on, you can turn him around, and you can keep it nice and cool and keeping that air going around the caravan. One thing that this has done an awesome job with is the fact that there's power almost everywhere. So you've got double power points and 12-volt sockets either side of the bed. You've got USBs everywhere. You've also got this bright LED hatch, and this guy here just pulls across. And then you've also got a pop-up hatch just here at the front. Goes all the way up. This is brand new, never been used before, so we're giving it a bit of a workout, and that just pops like so. But if the day's a little bit shite, or alternatively, you just need to be able to get a little bit of block out for some shut-eye, you can just close him off. You've got a true reverse cycle Bel Air 2400 air conditioning. Again, these are one of the awesome air conditioners. Low line, it's gonna keep you in, it's gonna get you into some of those tighter places, but it's a true reverse cycle unit, heating and cooling. We've got a heap of storage here as well with our shelving, of course, adjustable shelving. You've got one, two, three, and I think this is a flap underneath here for a bit of storage. There's a heap of storage. It's also accessible underneath the bunk bed, underneath the single beds, I should say, sorry. We have an NCE plateless microwave, so there's no plate in this guy. You just pop your food inside and everything goes around that. I'll just pop him off. We also have overhead cupboard here with all of our hot water, gas and electric, outside speakers, wireless lighting system, air conditioner plug and microwave plug. So still usable space everywhere. We've got our radio with a Bluetooth, inside and outside speakers. We have inside speakers here, of course. We also have 110 litre CFX Dometic fridge. So this guy here is a compressor. You've also got your freezer just like so. Just one little section with the compressor located in there and wire shelving throughout. Little flaps located everywhere in this guy as well. So again, fully insulated composite roof. This guy's strong as anything. We take full advantage of obviously the constructional methods, but again, buy Australian made. You're always going to have the parts available to you. You're always going to know that there's backup service around the whole country with a national warranty. This guy here is an off-road unit, so all gazetted roads in Australia are fully covered. This guy pulls up, midge-proof fly screens there, of course, and then the windows just very easily open up with a nice click on that. Very, very easy to use and utilize. Making our way through here before I show you the nice cooking area in here, we've got our shower. So our shower, we've got window to the side, we've got our flick mixer tap there, we've got our shower head just like so, LED light above. We've got a basin located in this. This is a separate unit. So we heard a bit of feedback from people in relation to the Chameleon hybrids. They wanted that bowl, so we've gone ahead and installed one of them. Obviously it's a watertight area. We've got our shower screen just like so, as far as like a little packaway bag. We have our FET for toilet, we showed you on the outside. Comes with chemicals, of course. That's a flushable system, so you just give it a good clean out and use it as you need. Alternatively, don't use it at all, it's completely up to you. And then we've got a watertight overhead cupboard here at the front. So all your shampoos, conditioners, everything like that. It's a heap of space in here. So the unit itself is probably about 800 to 900 wide, a massive unit. So the floor, of course, you've got a nice high quality plastic insertable floor here. These guys have done a fantastic job with the CRV units as far as having a shower combination unit in such a small 12-foot caravan. So the most important part to some, we've got our kitchen. So obviously we've got our filter water tap, our standard water tap. We have our sink with obviously smell traps located in there for all of our gray water. We have our recessed cooktop up the top here with our four burners for gas. We have a grill as well. We also have our pot drawer. We also have another pot drawer, because why wouldn't you in a van that's 12 foot? We have our range hood as well as our fan with light. overhead cupboard storage throughout this whole unit. So there's a massive amount of storage and it's all clean. Like, look at the attention to detail that Crusader go to. All the areas are gapped, all of it's plywood, all of it is well finished with 16 mil ply board. They've put so much thought into this. The strength factor of it is absolutely insane. Again, check this out. Heap of air coming through that. Imagine just parked up here, doing a bit of washing up, whatever it may be, and you've got straight out to the beach. Whatever you're looking at, there is a heap to love about the CRV. Pack this guy away, close him off, ready to go to bed. We've got our wooden top looks. Now, of course, you don't have to go for the wood. There are a heap of other options as well. There's a few different color selections like Moonlight, Starlight, all those bits and pieces you can sit down with your dealer and have a bit of a look at. Cupboard door smell trap located under there, so you don't get that on all the CRV builds. We've got our drawer. This little access panel in here, like a little safe, but we won't show you that. We've got another drawer, and another drawer, because why not? Now, just to finish it off, construction ability. So we've got 16 mil front-facing drawer fronts. We've got metal-sided drawer runners on all of the drawers, including the large pot drawers. The actual board itself highlighted within it. No timber in the drawer construction. This guy here is a polyplastic construction at the back and the bottom. So that is a full polycarb plastic material. So that means spilling water, soy sauce, anything like that, nothing's gonna ingress into the drawer. So again, massive sale point between this and our competitors. Everything is customly built by someone in a factory with a drill, building everything with you. A separate production line that complements the Crusader in the Crusader factory, built just in here in Epping, within Campbellfield, near Campbellfield. Just before we love you and leave you, we've got our water pump fire, our night mode on our PM200, and our load system switch. So what the load system does is it allows you to turn the whole caravan on, turn the whole caravan off. It's fair to say that within this range, the three vans, the Hurricane, the Esperance, and the Gladiator is absolutely my favorite. You've got an off-road, a semi-off-road van that you're gonna be able to do all of your articulate movings, all of your semi-off-road stuff, all of your gazetta roads, not a worry in the world. The Hurricane is one step above that with your airbag independent suspension and pretty much every single extra you could ever think of. That retails around the 90 mark. This guy here sits within that mid to high 50s, depending on what you add to it. And the Esperance is one step below that, but that is just tarmac roads. If you'd like to know more, head to our website for more information at www.crusadercaravansmelbourne.com.au. Alternatively, give me a call on 9359-2938-03 for Victorian area code. Or alternatively, like and subscribe to the next one. We have a heap more coming out. We hope to see you soon. Get your orders in fast and not miss the 2021 deadline on the Chameleon and CRV range. See you later, guys.